H2O2 producing H2O plus oxygen. You know the molecular weight is 34. You know equivalent weight of H2O2 is 17. Spoken of it. Now 68 grams, as you could see, is going to produce 22.4 liters of oxygen and NTP. Yes or no?
Yes,
68 grams of H2O2 will produce 22.4 liters of oxygen and NTP. Yes or no? Now 17 grams will thus produce 5.6 liters of oxygen and NTP. 17 grams will produce 5.6 liters of oxygen and NTP. Yes or no? Now you will want to take 17 grams of pure H2O2. You will want to take 17 grams of pure H2O2. Add enough water to make it 1 liter. You will want to take 17 grams of pure H2O2, and going by the stoichiometry, it is pretty evident that 68 grams is giving you 1 mole, which is, you know, 22.4 liters is the molar volume. So at NTP, 68 grams is going to give you 22.4 liters. So 17 grams will give you 5.6 liters. Take 17 grams of pure H2O2, add enough water, make it 1 liter. Now see if I can call it 1 liter of 1 normal H2O2. Can I call it 1 liter of 1 normal H2O2? Can I call it 1 liter of 1 normal H2O2? 17 grams is the equivalent weight. 17 grams is 1 equivalent. Here you have taken 1 equivalent of H2O2, obtained 1 liter solution. So it's 1 liter of 1 normal H2O2 containing 1 equivalent per liter. Yes or no? And potentially, this containing 17 grams, this 1 liter can give you 5.6 liters of oxygen. 1 liter can give you 5.6 liters of oxygen. So that way, you can call it 5.6 volume. That way, you can call it 5.6 volume. Yes or no? Now, this is going to look a little different, but believe me, this is difficult nowhere. I've told you about volume strength. You know about equivalent weight and normality. You know, 1 equivalent per liter will make it 1 normal. So 17 grams, and if it's 1 liter, it's 1 liter of 1 normal H2O2. And because 1 liter of this solution can give you 5.6 liters of oxygen, I can call it 5.6 volume also. So what I propose is, whether you call it 1 normal or 5.6 volume, it's the same. You find a solution which is 1 normal, is also 5.6 volume. So whether you call it 1 normal or you call it 5.6 volume, it is the same. Certainly if it is x normal, the volume strength will be 5.6 into x. So the volume strength would be 5.6 times normality. The volume strength will be 5.6 times normality. Got me? Problem hai koi? Can still think over it, but this is the, you know, most convenient way in which I could relate the two. I took one equivalent of it, made 1 liter of it. The 1 equivalent per liter would make it 1 normal. This should not object to me calling it 1 normal, and because 1 liter is giving me 5.6 liters, this was the premise of defining volume strength. 1 liter producing 5.6 liters, you know the volume strength is 5.6. So whether you call it 1 normal or 5.6 volume, it's the same. So 2 normal will be twice 5.6 volume. X normal solution would be 5.6x volume H2O2. Got me? So volume strength will be normality into 5.6. Next one would be percent strength and volume strength. Percent strength and volume strength. This was normality with volume strength. Now percent strength with volume strength, and we'll do something of the same kind. But this time, well, if 68 grams, we will want to move to ml now. 68 grams will produce 2 to 400 ml of oxygen and NTP. Yes or no? 1 gram would produce 2 to 4 double 0 upon 68, and you will get almost 329 ml of oxygen. So, it will be 329.14. So, if 68 grams produce 2 to 4 double 0 ml of oxygen, 1 gram will produce almost 329 ml of oxygen at NTP. Yet again, you will want to take 1 gram of pure H2O2, take 1 gram of pure H2O2, take 1 gram of pure H2O2, and maybe you will want to add enough water. Take 1 gram of pure H2O2, you will want to add enough water to make it 100 ml. Take 1 gram of pure H2O2, add enough water to make it 100 ml. And let me call it 100 ml of 1% H2O2. See if I can call it 100 ml of 1% H2O2, because it is 1 gram per 100 ml. It is 1 gram per 100 ml, yes or no? So, I can call it 100 ml of 1% H2O2, and 100 ml capable of producing 329 ml of oxygen. 100 ml of solution potentially capable of producing 329 ml of oxygen. What will be the volume strength here? 100 ml giving 329 ml of oxygen. 3.29? I don't know what you people are wondering at, you know. I don't know what you are trying to calculate or how difficult you are finding. 329 upon 100 will be 3.29. If you all agree to that, 100 ml giving you 329 ml, so 1 ml has to give you 3.29 ml. Yes or no? So 100 ml producing 329 ml, and you see whether you call it 1% or you call it, well, 3.29 volume, it's the same. So the relationship between percentage and volume strength would be, if it's x percent, if it's x percent, it's 3.29x volume H2O2. So volume strength will be percentage strength into 3.29. Volume strength will be percentage strength into 3.29. And you saw that volume strength would be normality into 5.6. Got me? Problem hai koi? And certainly, as I said in the past, you know, your understanding of it is going to grow with the application, some problems which you solve on H2O2. But it was very necessary for me, you know, to tell you about this unit of measuring strength, and then we wanted to relate it to normality or percentage, which are the conventional units. Fair enough. This much for today.